Why the Idaho earthquake swarm has scientists losing sleep? Could the ground beneath Idaho be preparing for the most devastating earthquake in American history? The earth under central Idaho has been experiencing unprecedented seismic activity, with over 100 earthquakes recorded in recent weeks. Seismologists are watching their monitoring equipment with growing alarm as this earthquake swarm continues to defy normal patterns, maintaining intensity levels that typically decrease over time. The latest magnitude earthquakes are still registering on monitoring systems, and the frequency shows no signs of the natural decline that would indicate underlying geological stress is being relieved. Be sure to keep watching until the end of this video, because I'm going to reveal how this earthquake swarm is exhibiting the exact same pattern that preceded some of the most catastrophic seismic disasters in recorded history, and why scientists are quietly preparing for a scenario that could reshape the entire Pacific Northwest. So don't click away. You won't want to miss these terrifying geological warning signs that suggest we might be witnessing the early stages of something unprecedented. This isn't your typical earthquake situation. The area around Stanley, Idaho has been experiencing what geologists call an earthquake swarm, but this one is behaving in ways that are making experts seriously uncomfortable. The magnitude 4.0 earthquake that initiated the sequence was notable enough, but what happened next is what has scientists on edge. Instead of the usual pattern where aftershocks gradually decrease in frequency and magnitude, this swarm has maintained its intensity and even shown signs of escalation. What makes this particularly alarming is the location. We're talking about the same region that produced Idaho's second largest earthquake in recorded history, the magnitude 6.5 Stanley earthquake. But here's where things get really concerning. The current swarm is happening on a completely different fault system. That previous major earthquake occurred on the Sawtooth Fault, which geologists had been monitoring for years. This new activity is revealing faults that we literally didn't know existed until this swarm began. The strike slip motion being recorded is what's really got seismologists worried. Most earthquakes in this region involve vertical movement, the ground moving up and down. Strike slip motion means the ground is sliding horizontally past itself, and this type of movement can store and release far more energy than vertical motion. It's the same type of movement that powers the San Andreas Fault in California, and we all know how that story goes. Seismologists studying earthquake patterns in the region are calling this swarm deeply concerning because it's exhibiting characteristics typically seen before major seismic events. The continuous nature of the activity, combined with the gradual increase in frequency rather than the expected decrease, suggests that enormous amounts of stress are building up underground rather than being released through these smaller earthquakes. This exact pattern has been documented before major earthquakes around the world. The 2011 magnitude 9.0 Tohoku earthquake in Japan was preceded by a similar swarm of smaller earthquakes that lasted for weeks. The 1906 San Francisco earthquake followed a months-long period of increased seismic activity. The devastating 2016 earthquake sequence in central Italy began with what appeared to be harmless earthquake swarms that gradually intensified until the main shock devastated entire towns. The new fault discovery changes everything we thought we understood about seismic risk in central Idaho. For decades, risk assessments have been based on known fault systems. But the revelation that there are active fault lines we haven't even mapped yet means our understanding of the region's seismic potential has been dangerously incomplete. Building codes, emergency preparedness plans, and infrastructure development have all been based on fundamentally flawed assumptions about earthquake risk. Recent seismic data shows stress patterns underground that suggest the current activity might just be the beginning. The earthquakes aren't randomly distributed. They're following clear geological trends that indicate systematic movement along fault structures. This organized pattern of seismic activity is exactly what geologists look for when trying to identify areas where larger earthquakes might be building toward release. Most earthquake swarms last days, not weeks, and they typically show clear signs of decreasing energy over time. This swarm is defying those expectations, maintaining its intensity and showing no signs of natural decline. Every piece of data suggests that whatever is driving this activity underground is still building pressure, still loading stress onto fault systems that we're only beginning to understand. Computer modeling from the United States Geological Survey paints a terrifying picture of what a magnitude 7+ earthquake would do to this exact region. The simulations aren't theoretical exercises. They're based on the geological realities that this earthquake swarm is revealing. When seismologists input the newly discovered fault characteristics and the current stress patterns into their models, the results show potential ground acceleration levels that would exceed what most structures in central Idaho were designed to withstand. The domino effect starts with infrastructure that was never built to handle this level of seismic activity. Central Idaho's major dams, including several that provide critical water supply and flood control for downstream communities, become potential weapons of mass destruction in a major earthquake scenario. The Palisades Dam, which holds back over 1.2 million acre-feet of water, sits directly in a seismically active zone. Computer simulations show that a magnitude 7 earthquake would compromise the dam's structural integrity within minutes, sending a wall of water downstream that would make Hurricane Katrina look like a minor flooding event. But the dam's failures are just the beginning of the nightmare scenario. Central Idaho's transportation infrastructure creates what emergency planners call a geographic trap for tens of thousands of people. Highway 75, the primary route through the Stanley Basin, runs directly through the earthquake zone we're monitoring. A major seismic event would trigger massive landslides that could block this crucial corridor for months, not days. Interstate 84, the state's primary east-west transportation artery, crosses multiple bridges that haven't been retrofitted to modern seismic standards. When these fail, and geological modeling suggests they will, entire communities become cut off from emergency services, medical care, and supply deliveries. The 72-hour timeline is where things get truly catastrophic. Within the first hour, emergency communication systems fail as cell towers topple and power grids collapse. The mountainous terrain that makes Idaho beautiful becomes a death trap, as emergency responders can't reach isolated communities. Hospitals in the region, already operating at capacity, face structural damage while dealing with a massive influx of casualties. Medical helicopters can't land if airports are damaged, and ground ambulances can't navigate destroyed roadways. Hey guys, before moving on, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give a thumbs up if you haven't already. Make sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on our daily videos. By day 3, the situation becomes apocalyptic. Food supplies in rural communities, which typically maintain only a few days' worth of inventory, are exhausted. Water treatment facilities damaged by the earthquake can't provide safe drinking water, leading to public health crises. Fuel supplies run out, making generators useless and vehicles inoperable. Rural communities that rely on tourism for economic survival face complete economic collapse as access roads remain impassable. The seismic activity we're currently witnessing could trigger what geologists call sympathetic failure in connected fault systems across the region. The Yellowstone region, just hours away, sits on a complex network of faults that respond to major seismic events elsewhere. Historical data shows that large earthquakes in central Idaho have triggered increased seismic activity near Yellowstone, and computer models suggest that a magnitude 7+ event could potentially destabilize other fault systems across Montana, Wyoming, and eastern Washington. Economic modeling shows the ripple effects extending far beyond the immediate disaster zone. The Pacific Northwest's economy depends heavily on transportation corridors that run directly through central Idaho. Rail lines carrying agricultural products from the Midwest to Pacific ports would be severed. Trucking routes that carry billions of dollars in goods annually would be impassable for months. The economic impact would cascade through supply chains, affecting everything from food prices in Seattle to manufacturing schedules in Portland. What makes this economic scenario particularly devastating is the timing uncertainty. Unlike hurricanes or other natural disasters that provide warning, major earthquakes strike without notice. Businesses have no time to relocate inventory, secure facilities, or implement contingency plans. The sudden nature of seismic disasters means that recovery efforts start from a position of complete unpreparedness, dramatically extending the timeline for economic recovery and amplifying the long-term financial devastation across multiple states. The connection between this earthquake swarm and Yellowstone's underground activity is what has geologists truly terrified, though they're reluctant to discuss it publicly. The two systems aren't separate geological features. They're part of an interconnected network of fault lines and magma chambers that respond to each other across hundreds of miles. Recent research has revealed that major seismic events in central Idaho have historically preceded increased thermal activity at Yellowstone by months or years. The current swarm sits directly on geological pathways that could transmit stress changes to the Yellowstone caldera system. What makes this connection so dangerous is that we're not just dealing with earthquake risk anymore. Seismic activity can alter underground hydrothermal systems, potentially destabilizing the delicate balance that keeps Yellowstone's supervolcano dormant. While a full eruption remains unlikely, even minor changes to Yellowstone's thermal features could release toxic gases, trigger localized explosions, or create new geothermal hazards that would affect millions of visitors in nearby communities. The seismic data from central Idaho is showing stress patterns that align with historical precursors to increased Yellowstone activity. But here's the cruel irony. While this geological powder keg is priming itself for potential disaster, more people are moving directly into harm's way than ever before. Central Idaho has experienced unprecedented population growth over recent years, with remote work opportunities and lifestyle changes driving urban refugees to seek mountain communities. The very areas showing the highest seismic risk are attracting new residents who have no experience with earthquake preparedness and no understanding of the geological realities beneath their new homes. Climate change is amplifying these seismic risks in ways that most people never consider. Rising temperatures are altering precipitation patterns, leading to more intense rainfall events that saturate soils and increase landslide susceptibility during earthquakes. Wildfire seasons are longer and more severe, leaving mountain slides stripped of vegetation that normally helps stabilize slopes during seismic events. When a major earthquake hits an area recently burned by wildfires, the combination creates catastrophic debris flows that can't travel for miles, wiping out everything in their path. The building codes currently governing construction in central Idaho are shockingly inadequate for the seismic realities we're discovering. Most structures in the region were built under standards developed when we understood far less about earthquake risk. Worse yet, many buildings predate any seismic requirements entirely. Retrofitting existing structures to modern earthquake standards would cost billions of dollars, money that rural communities simply don't have. New construction continues under codes that don't account for the newly discovered fault systems or the strike-slip motion that can generate far more destructive shaking than previously anticipated. Emergency preparedness in the region reflects this same dangerous gap between risk and reality. Local emergency services are designed for typical mountain emergencies, lost hikers, avalanches, structure fires. They're not equipped for mass casualty events involving thousands of people across a region where communication systems have failed and transportation networks are destroyed. The nearest major trauma centers are hours away under normal conditions and days away if highways are impassable. The window for meaningful preparation is closing rapidly. Every day this earthquake swarm continues represents another opportunity to implement emergency plans, stockpile supplies, and educate communities about seismic risks. But public attention spans are short, and without a major disaster to motivate action, most people will return to normal routines while the geological forces beneath their feet continue building toward an inevitable release. The most frightening aspect of this situation is its inevitability. Unlike other natural disasters that might be prevented or predicted, major earthquakes are geological certainties. The only questions are when and how large. The current swarm isn't just a curiosity for scientists. It's a warning system that we ignore at our own peril. If this video opened your eyes to the geological realities unfolding beneath our feet, here's something that keeps me wondering about our preparedness. If you live anywhere in the Pacific Northwest, how confident are you that your community could survive being completely cut off from outside help for weeks or even months? Let me know what you think in the comments below, and be sure to check out our videos on our end screens.